Everyone, my name is Minghong Chen. I'm an ECE PhD student from Georgia Tech. Today I'm going to talk about our CBPR paper, Action Segmentation with Joint Self-Supervised Temporal Domain Adaptation. This work was done when I did the internship at Baidu USA by collaborating with Baopu Li and Yingzi Bao from Baidu, and Professor Gaston Regib and Professor Zhou Kira from Georgia Tech. This paper is mainly addressing the problem of action segmentation. After feeding the video to the segmentation model, we can get output predictions for each frame. Given the success of deep learning, we can adopt standard supervised learning to train a model. The standard way to address this problem is to focus on designing more complicated or deeper architectures to improve the performance. However, if actions are performed by different people who are not included in the training data, directly applying the source model may not work. The main reason is that each person has his or her own style even when doing the same action, causing the variations across videos. Since annotating video data requires or consumes a lot of time and human labors, our goal becomes adapting the source model to make it work on target data without target labels. Adapting a model requires some target information, so we exploit unlabeled videos for model adaptation. Previously, people mainly focused on image-based domain adaptation or self-supervised learning to exploit unlabeled data to update source models. Different from their approaches, we propose self-supervised temporal domain adaptation, or abbreviated as SSTDA, to effectively reduce variations in videos and then get more accurate predictions. The quantitative results show that our approach outperforms others. We also show qualitative comparison by highlighting the difference from the ground truth. The difference is the less the better. And our method clearly shows better performance than others. The ultimate goal of this work is to reduce the annotation needs for machine learning. So it's particularly useful for video applications since annotating video is difficult. For example, dynamic scene understanding in autonomous vehicles, imitation learning for robotic arms using videos, or video-based sport analysis, and so on. Finally, feel free to check our paper and code for more details. And feel free to visit our poster number 93 in session 2.4 at CBPR. Thank you.